This morning, bright and early, the Hattie National Bank head office is to commence their monthly walk. So we were told that they began this last month as one of their CSR projects, and they hope to continue it every month under the slogan Walk the Talk. Their basic objective is to promote the reduction of carbon emissions by using commuting options such as walking or cycling or taking public transport. So stick around as we hope to find more information about this worthy cause and about its objectives and what the people involved think about it. I am Shalindri and you are with Pulse. This is Mr. Jonathan Alice, the CEO of HNB, and we wanted to ask him about this whole walk and why you think it's important for the company.
I think HNB has a long tradition of implementing sustainable initiatives, whether it's on the business front or whether it's inside in its office based on the green pledge that we have signed, and where staff themselves personally get involved at a head office, regional and a branch level to perform many CSR activities and sustainable banking initiatives. HNB played a lead role when we brought all the banks together for sustainable banking initiatives, which was actually funded from overseas DFIs as well. And right now we are working on the second phase of it. Now this aligns itself beautifully with, you know, our wellness, our health and happiness index, because it gives an opportunity for our staff to truly participate, engage in preserving energy, in conserving energy, in helping the environment, and at the same time improving your health as well. So many of us come walking if we are, you know, reasonably close by. There are many who come cycling, and then the others use public transport, be it the bus or the train service, in order to support this initiative. So if you go back to the car park, you will see no vehicles this morning. We started it last month as a trial to see whether we could actually do it on the last Friday of every month. Based on the resounding success and the feedback we received, we thought, let's see how it goes this month as well. Hopefully we will continue this and many other initiatives that will motivate, encourage our staff, our customers, and continue to be an important corporate for Sri Lanka.
Thank you so much. Thank you very much. And this is Mrs. Shiranti Kure, the Chief HR Officer, who has taken the bus today to come to work.
Hi, yes, we are doing Walk the Talk for the second month in succession, and this is due to popular request by our team at head office. There was a lot of energy and enthusiasm around this whole initiative last month when we started. So last month we closed the car park down. This month we made it voluntary, and you can see people milling around, coming by bus, train, pool vehicles, walking, cycling. So we believe this will take off, to a greater momentum.
So if you can tell us a little bit about the objectives and the commuting options.
The objective is to create awareness about being responsible citizens, you know, fuel emissions, climate change, being environmentally friendly. It's easy for us to all get into our vehicles and hit the road, but then there are other options available, and those are also workable. So by walking, cycling, taking a bus ride, train ride, a public commute, we are trying to share with our team and by example that everyone doesn't need to bring all their cars and, you know, maybe pollute the environment.
Very true. So is it only the head office that's involved with this, or what do you want?
At this point of time, it's only the head office. We hope through our sustainability unit that the regions will take a cue on this, but we are mindful of the commute difficulties on the terrains. So maybe they might opt to do it, maybe once a quarter or once a year as a symbolic gesture. There's no compulsion here. We hope that our staff will, on their own, individually, apart from today and the next month or whatever, take a cue from this and become more responsible Earth citizens.
Thank you so much. Mr. Chanel Pereira, who is here to talk to us about the CSR side of this project.
Hi, good morning. I'm the Office in Charge of Sustainable Business. Actually, this is our second campaign of the, we call it as HNB Walk the Talk. And we really wanted to make this happen to reduce the carbon emission and make the public to aware that how the environment is polluted. And we urge all the other corporates, and we invite all the other corporates to participate for this kind of event. Even at the HNB head office, we have 1,200 odd amount of people. So we have told them to avoid to use their personal vehicles, because around 200 vehicles is parked inside our building. So if all the other corporates also could join and join hands together and make it a success, actually we could able to reduce the traffic congestions in Colombo. We could able to do a lot of things and make a carbon-free environment.
Thank you so much. Here we have Mr. Hemantha Senaviratna, the Assistant Manager of Sustainable Business. He's here to tell us what he thinks about the walk. Yeah?
Yeah, we started this initiative to reduce our carbon emissions as well as to reduce traffic congestion in Colombo, to showcase what we can do in maybe in a small way. But I think if other companies also can join with us, someday we will be able to have a traffic-free Colombo. So our main objective of this initiative is to reduce carbon emissions. We park about 200 vehicles in this building, and normally about 150 of them are owned by our staff members. So if we reduce about 50% of those vehicles, we can save about 600 liters of petrol. Through that saving, we can reduce about 1,380 kilograms of carbon emissions. So that is the impact of this initiative, and I request all companies in Sri Lanka to join with us and help us to have a more habitable Colombo.
Thank you so much. We have Mr. Piekara and Ms. Shiromi, who took part in the walk today. Hi, good morning.
Good morning.
Looking all pumped up and having a cola can and all?
Well, pumped up, I wouldn't know, after walking 10 kilometers. Yes, we feel awesome, great.
Yeah.
Okay, so what do you think about this this whole project in general?
Shiromi? Well, I think the initiative taken by the bank is really great. One thing is that looking after the health of the employees is a great initiative, and plus looking at the carbon footprint, of course both of us have our own vehicles and we have left them home, or and we'll not be using it today. So the carbon footprint that we keep today is quite great, and then this will definitely lead a little bit of a leeway for somebody to live a little longer, where we have not wasted the energy and we have used our own energy to reach here. So it was awesome to walk from Palavatta. Yeah. She walked from Palavatta, I walked from Bhattaramula Jayantipura. So we both of us got together at Parliament grounds, and then we walked the entire distance. Started off around 5:45, reached here 7:05, and it was awesome. And it's great. Yeah, still enjoying. Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much. Thanks. And this is Mr. Christopher. And I heard that you are an active participant of this.
I think a lifestyle of fitness and health is something that I have been following myself for a long time. So I'm a strong advocate of it. If you take foreign countries, for example, there are a lot of people who cycle to work on a daily basis, and it's part and parcel of their culture. So the fact that we started it here, I think it's a great initiative to create awareness for all the people in the city, in the country as well, about the benefits of not taking the car all the time, and actually just walking and contributing to the, let's say, the greenery and the carbon emissions and so on, reducing the carbon emissions in the area. Plus, it's a win-win because you become fit and it's good for your health, right? And it's a lot of fun. So I'm glad we're doing it again. We did it recently before. And so let's hope we continue to do this the last Friday of every month, as the management had decided. It's a great one.
Thank you so much.